Thank you, m'lady. He deserved to be a real boy. And it sure was nice of you to... Huh? Well, I'll be... My, my. Solid gold, too. Oh, I think it's swell.
When your heart is in your dream, no request is too extreme.
Celebration!
60 years ago, the incredible film Pinocchio taught us all that when you wish upon a star, dreams really can come true. And the man who dreamed it up was Walt Disney. In 1937, Walt created something no one had ever seen before. The first full-length animated feature, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. It dazzled audiences worldwide. But now, Walt had a problem. What to do next? People in the movie business begged him to repeat the formula. Give us more dwarfs, they said. But Walt Disney was too original for that. Instead, he found a serialized magazine story. The tale of a wooden puppet who wants to become a real boy.
Oh, look, Father! Look!
The Blue Fairy gave life with one stroke of her wand.
What they can't do these days.
But giving life to an imaginary world was much more difficult.
Oh, look! My nose!
Actual production of Pinocchio lasted more than 2 years and required over 750 artists and technicians. Many new techniques were developed during the making of Pinocchio, as animators faced an array of new challenges. For instance, how do you create the effect of being underwater?
Look out below!
Their answer was to pull a piece of corrugated glass across the animation cells, giving the effect of ripples in the water. In fact, the underwater sequences in Pinocchio established a new standard that paved the way for many Disney masterpieces to come, including The Little Mermaid. In Walt's imagination, the world of make-believe was very real. He insisted that the animation must imitate life. Above all else, the illusion had to be believable. He had three-dimensional models built of many of the cuckoo clocks and Pinocchio, so that the artists could study their movements. The model of the coachman's carriage was even fitted with shock absorbers to make sure that Jiminy bounced over every bump in the road.
Here we go again.
In addition to the use of models, they went one step further when drawing their characters. They studied their own faces reflected in mirrors so they could capture a full range of expressions. One of the key animators was Ward Kimball, the animation director for Jiminy Cricket.
Walt Disney was a great actor. He'd get up, he'd be carried away with the characters. He'd get on Pinocchio, and he'd act out Foul Fellow, the way he'd strut. And we'd watch him, and our jaws would drop.
Walt was the ultimate perfectionist. It took 12 different animators 18 months to create a Pinocchio that met his approval.
Pinocchio!
But Walt knew that Pinocchio needed something more, a loyal friend and advisor.
Cricket's the name. Jiminy Cricket.
When Walt said that I was in charge of the cricket, I said, well, this should be easy. I'll see what a realistic cricket looks like. And ugh, I kept eliminating all of the appendages, the feelers and the sawtooth legs and arms. And I kept at it until finally he says, I can live with that.
Jiminy became the first in the long tradition of helpful Disney sidekicks, like Timothy, Sebastian, and another famous cricket, Cricky from Mulan. Over the years, many fine actors have brought their gifts to the classic Disney films. For the part of Pinocchio, Walt cast child actor Dickie Jones.
A lot of times they would come in and they would get real close with a small camera and just photograph our nose, our mouth, and our chin. as we were doing the dialogue, so that the animators could actually see how a nose would work and the lips would move to form the certain words.
But Jiminy!
You buttered your bread! Now sleep in it!
In the case of Jiminy Cricket, Cliff Edwards, who did the voice, had that personality in his voice. He had a way of talking to Pinocchio.
Here's what we'll tell him. You can't go to the theater. Say thank you just the same. You're sorry, but you've got to go to school.
Mm-hmm.
So we just animated to that voice, and that became the personality. And that was a lucky marriage of visual design and the sound of his very friendly voice.
Gee, thanks.
After 60 years, Pinocchio still remains one of the most beloved family films of all time. Through its endearing characters, innovative animation, and wonderful storytelling, Pinocchio continues to remind all of us to dream, and then to wish upon a star.